Hello, hello, everybody. How's everybody doing? How's your mom and dam? oh, my fucking word. All right, I got some Dan calls lined up here to play. If the title, you know, didn't give it away, I just did. We listened to some Dan stuff here. And, yeah, let's say hi to everybody and then let's just get into it. Slash, good to see ya. I'm not late. I am perfectly on time. Eureka's mom, good to see ya. Zabram, of course. Respected, as Jesse might say. Outdoor Loser, Cornville Counselor. Mandy S, good to see you, Mandy S. Provision of Grief, good to see you. Fuck, it just jumped on me again. Alright, I think I'm here. Nuggies, good to see you, Nuggies. I'm coming to Cornville. I haven't seen you in a while. How you doing? I'm coming to Cornville. And, alright, I think that's all we got here, so... Let's get into the call. First call is another Lauren and Dan showdown. So it's, it's going to be a classic here. It's another Lauren and Dan showdown. It's like a classic, a classic West movie title or something. And as usual, I'm right in the fucking middle of it.
You've reached Lauren Armstrong. Leave a message.
At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may...
Hey, Dad, damn doctor.
Hang on, let me read your other message.
Let me read your other message.
What the fuck is that? Because it sounds like a guy. It sounds like Dan.
Oh my god. Oh my god. I think we can't hear what's going on the other
end. Oh, really, huh?
Okay, yes, we definitely can't hear what's going on the other end.
How much have you been fucking talking? You've reached Lauren Armstrong. Leave a message.
Leave a message.
That wasn't your fault. That was mine. I lost my signal. How much have you been talking to this queer?
Oh my god. Mr. Potty Mouth over here. Jesus.
Don't fucking lie to me. Don't lie to me. I don't need to ask him. He sent me a message that let me know that you've been talking to him a lot.
A lot.
Is he really? Let me read this message to you.
Message.
Hang on. Let me fucking bring it up. Hang on. Hang on. You want to hear the message? Hang on. Let me bring it up so I can read it to you.
Hey, Mary Hirsch.
This is his message. I'm confident that if you and your girlfriend call me, I'll take her within 5 minutes. You bitch boy. You ain't got the balls to do it.
What the fuck? You ain't got the balls to do it. Did you hear how he said that? That was
bitch
good.
Boy. You ain't got the balls to do it.
Why did he sing that?
Bitch boy. You ain't got the balls to do it.
You ain't got the balls to do it. Hey, Clementine. And Kit Kat Meow, good to see you.
How much have you been talking to this fucking queer?
How much of you have you been talking to this guy?
How willing are you, how much are you willing to lose me for this fucking queer?
How much are you willing to lose me for this gentleman? How much are you willing to lose me?
So he'll tell me the truth?
I don't like school.
You better keep
in
mind, you just may lose me if you say the wrong fucking thing. I think you better tell him off. I don't think it. I know it.
I don't think it?
You better fucking tell him off. Because you'll lose me if you don't.
Okay, so if anyone can add any clarification, you know, you're more than welcome to. But I'm pretty sure what's happening here is that this is Winnie, I'm pretty sure. And she's in the hospital, and whatever her, like, hospital room mate, whatever his name is, he's there, and he's texting Lauren shit. That's what I think is happening.
Hello?
Hey, Dr. Cunt.
What's up, Dan?
What's up, Dan?
Hey, what's up, chicken tenders?
Oh, there it is. Boom, boom, boom. Classic line. Boom. I didn't even know it was this call.
Hey, what's up, chicken tenders?
There it is.
What are you doing, you fucking ball sucker?
Ooh.
No, that hasn't happened yet.
And then you're engaged to a fucking guy.
I
not be a fucking ball sucker.
Let me tell you something, Lauren. I got 8 inches, okay?
8 inches.
8 inches.
You have eating issues? Yeah, you go for meatballs.
What?
I got 8 inches down your throat.
Hey, going for meatballs.
Yeah, you're 8 inches. You ain't going down my throat. I'll fucking kill you.
Hey, does anyone think Lauren is drunk?
You think you're putting the fucking any inches towards my fucking throat, you'll be dead.
I'm gonna hold you by the ears, boy, and I'm gonna.
I'm homophobic, motherfucker. I'm homophobic, motherfucker. I don't go for your queer shit.
I'm gonna fuck your face with my 8 inches cock.
My 8 inches.
Why don't
cock.
You meet me in person to say that, bitch?
I'm coming.
You don't dare to you.
Hey.
Because you're a fucking scared ass old motherfucker.
I'm gonna kick your ass. You'll say it on the phone
because you're a fucking chicken shit.
Hey, Sprinkle Cake. Thanks. I like doing them.
You ain't got the balls.
Why don't you say that face to me? Face to face.
Yeah, there it is.
Why don't you say that to me face to face? See how long you fucking last.
Hey, shut up, bitch.
Don't call my fucking woman a bitch, you fucking piece of shit, fucking queer.
Bitch.
You're a fucking queer. You couldn't even satisfy Emma. You're a fucking queer.
She's gonna be sucking my cock within the week. I'm
oh, really?
Yeah.
What if I talk to her, Dan? You don't have a chick.
This is not the Dan I have come to know and love. Dan, what happened?
Shut up, bitch. Yeah.
Dan had a tough day in the courtroom and in the boxing ring.
Shut up, you fucking queer. If me and Casey talk to Emma, you ain't never seeing Emma again.
You ain't never talking to Emma, okay? I got everybody
really?
Where I
want. I am the only one that has not deleted off Emma's phone. You don't have a chance against me, Dan.
Well, Eureka's mom, he needs to make sure that he's heard at least 2 times because he's the most important person in the universe, so.
I have
well, everybody. In case you talk to Emma,
talking about?
You you're done. Emma. You will never, ever fucking touch Emma again.
I'll touch who I want, when I want, and how I want.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm taking
well,
both.
Why don't you stand face to face with me, Dan, and say that, you fucking queer?
One, I got your bitch, okay?
You don't have my bitch.
I got your bitch.
My woman sticks with me.
No.
Then why is she all over
my woman loves me.
Didn't she already why glow
down? She don't give a fuck about you.
She's learning
right now the exact kind of person that you are.
Why? Shut up, bitch. Why is she on
don't fucking call her a bitch, you fucking piece of shit, fucking queer.
Yeah, there you go.
That only sucks fucking asshole.
8 inches.
Asshole cock.
8 inches down balls? Your throat, bitch.
If it's only asshole and cock, what about the balls? You started, Lauren, you started with the balls, buddy. Stick to the balls.
Hang up on that fucking queer. I don't want to hear his fucking voice. He's a fucking gay. If he had any respect for any of us, And if he was actually friends with any of us, he would not talk like this.
This is a classic Lauren tactic. If he was actually my friend, he would do everything that I wanted him to do. If she was actually in love with me, she would do everything I wanted her to do. Classic Lauren.
I'm still friends with any of us. And if you had any respect for any of us, he wouldn't talk like this. Hang up on that fucking queer.
Hang up on him.
Shut up, bitch.
Sounds like Lauren's got a dick in his mouth.
Hey, you fucking queer. I haven't met you in person. I will fucking literally fucking beat the hell out of you.
I'm going to rip your fucking head off if I see you in person, you fucking pedophile.
Fuck you, fucking queer. You don't have a fucking chance.
You satisfy your woman because you like fucking little kids. That's why.
You fucking queer.
Got him.
Probably my woman knows better.
What, do you want to play with fucking little girls in the fucking kiddie pool?
Yeah, Cyberscree, I did. I lined it up perfectly. I manipulated your day in subtle ways to get you to come in late so that I would line up the call perfectly. I have some major manipulation skills. You try to put manipulations on me.
Pool, you fucking ass.
I'm gonna play with you fucking bitch in the fucking ring and I just beat the hell out of you, you fucking queer. My woman knows exactly what kind of person I am.
Set it up.
So you don't have a chance, faggot. Hey, fag. You even undermine your own fucking woman that you had before. Because right. you already know she loves me more than she loves you.
What is your boxing?
She loves Casey more than she loves you.
What is your boxing name on? Shut up.
You don't have a chance.
What is your boxing name? The Canvas King?
She's going to listen to me, Casey, long before she does you, because she knows that you don't fight. You're a fucking piece of shit.
If you're standing face to face with
Bye, faggot. Casey, hang that phone up on him right now.
I'm going to tear your fucking head off, Lauren. Shut up, bitch.
Classic coward. I've said what I wanted to say. Now hang up on him.
Come up here, faggot. Knew it. Come up here, faggot.
Yeah, Cybersqueak, I think that it helps that, like, he's trying to admonish someone else for their sexual orientation when he is, like, famous for being a sexual deviant. Like, it carries no weight because he has no ground to stand on when criticizing someone else's sexuality. So it's like, you know, I can appreciate if someone's offended by it, but I don't know. It's easy to dismiss him. And also, I paused the video on 9 minutes and 11 seconds, so...
Come up here and do it, fag boy! You got my address, fag boy! Come up here and do it, you fucking queer!
I'm gonna fuck you up!
Come on, bitch! Bring it on, you fucking faggot!
Come on, you wanna arm wrestle me right now, motherfucker?
Bring it up here!
Fucking
arm wrestle you!
Oh, Jesus Christ!
I'm wrestling you, I don't wanna beat the little fuck out of you, you stupid bitch!
I'm gonna fucking smack you right in the fucking face!
Fight, fag boy, fight!
You're fucking arm wrestle!
Not arm wrestle.
You're gonna make you get your fucking head beat in, faggot!
Sucker!
Come up here, fag boy!
I'm coming to Cornville!
Come on, fag! Shout out, I'm coming to Cornville. There it is. Boom, boom, boom. You made your grand return. And Dan says your name. There you go. Look at you. An unbelievable.
You know my address, little bitch. My address is not hidden. Come on, fag boy.
Shut up, bitch. I'm gonna tear you
out. Hey, bitch, you fucking call my number. Bitch, you fucking little. Faggot.
He's been calling her that for minutes.
So fucking tear this dude apart.
Hey, there are some queers up here too. You might be able to go to a fucking Blue Moon Bar and fucking tag you a couple of queers.
Well, perfect.
Okay, so he's threatening Dan, but also he genuinely wants Dan to come and visit. So he's like, hey, just like as a sweetener, you know, if you come up here and actually visit me, you know, we obviously won't fight. I'll go hide in the woods until, you know, the steam blows over. But then you can have sex with some men at the Blue Moon Bar. So, Dan, come on. What more do I have to do for you to come up here?
Then I can go up to Cornville.
Sounds like Lauren might have heard about that 8 inches cock and, you know, got some ideas. He's really desperate for Dan to get up there.
So I'm married up to hell as a woman.
Then I'll fuck you up.
Come on, brother. Bring it up here. Hello, you know my address. I'll fuck you up, bitch. I will allow you to step in my driveway, but one step is all you're going to get.
Why? What's going to happen?
One step is all it takes.
Happen.
Hey, Kimus.
You're going to be back on the pavement, brother. I'm telling you that right now. You'll be back on the pavement so fast, you will never even have a fucking clue about where you were.
What?
Do you know, Lauren, that if I come up to Cornville, your girlfriend is going to have to watch me annihilate you, and then I'm going to mouth fuck you in front of her.
Oh, wow.
And I also know that you're dreaming.
You're dreaming.
You're far from fucking dreaming. Because you know if you fucking come up to Cornville and you step in my fucking driveway.
Driveway?
You're going to go home. You just might go in a fucking body bag.
Body.
In a body bag? Really, Lauren?
Did they both say it, body?
Really, Dan? You want to test your fucking luck? You bring your ass up here. I am telling you right now, you bring your fucking ass up
here. Me now.
I will guarantee you, you will not go home in a body bag because I know you have family members that care about you.
What?
So you will not go home in a body bag.
Okay.
But you will go to the hospital before you go home.
Okay.
You can bring all your... Shut up, bitch. You can bring all...
Hey, you fucking queer. Hey. Don't call my woman a bitch, you fucking stupid fucking piece of shit queer.
I just did.
I like how it's not don't call her a bitch. Don't call Casey or Winnie or whoever this is. It's don't call my woman a bitch.
Yeah, well, Casey, hang up on the motherfucker.
Shut up, bitch. I'll smack you.
Casey. Oh, Roy, hey!
Hey,
bitch ass fucking queer. Why don't you fucking bring your ass up here? Bring your ass up here, motherfucker. Because I'm going to show you what a real fucking smack is. You don't dare to. You know why? Because you're a chicken shit. You're a chicken shit piece of bitch fucking queer.
You're a chicken shit piece of bitch fucking queer. Let's get that again. Yeah, Cornville Counselor. I think he's talking about that muddy patch of destroyed land. That's what he means by driveway.
You don't dare to. You know why? Because you're a chicken shit. You're a chicken shit piece of bitch fucking queer.
Chicken shit piece of bitch fucking queer. Is that right? Did I get that right?
Don't you're a chicken shit. You're a...
Chicken shit. So those are the first two words. Chicken shit.
Chicken shit piece of bitch fucking queer.
Yeah, chicken shit piece of bitch fucking queer. How is that not somebody's username?
Lauren, have you ever been turned down?
You don't dare to fucking face me, Dan.
Do you want me to put you in the...
You talk to fucking talk, but you don't have any fucking balls to walk the walk because they've been sucked off.
What?
I'm coming up to
court. Shut the fuck up to my woman. Don't ever fucking call her a bitch. Faggot. Shut up, you fucking faggot. Casey, hang up on that goddamn cocksucker now.
You don't want to face me. That's
hang
why.
Up on him, Casey. Casey. Now.
I'm afraid of him. Hang up on him.
Now, do you see how that fucking faggot is? Do you really think that fucking faggot is worth fucking risking me and you?
Wow, good point, Lauren. Keep using slurs. That's gonna help.
So now, what do you think about Emma? You want Emma to be with some piece of shit like that?
Piece of shit, bitch. Wait. Fuck.
You do?
I already forgot.
Come on,
chicken
now.
Shit, piece of bitch. Chicken shit,
after
piece
she
of
was
bitch.
There for you. Out of all your stuff, she is your best friend.
Oh, Casey's here.
Are you really going to stick up for him? He called you a bitch.
Why did he do that?
Casey.
Casey.
shake the goddamn cobwebs out of your fucking head.
What?
What the fuck is the matter with you? Are you crying about this fucking queer? I'm not yelling at you, I'm talking to you.
Yeah, he's not yelling, you guys. Just because he's raising his voice doesn't mean he's yelling.
My mind is blown right now because you're crying because of this fucking queer? No. Are you serious?
No. Are you serious?
Your fucking queer friend that you've been fucking talking to behind my back is still texting me. Well, you must have been.
Yeah, I'm coming to Cornville. Lauren calls her a bitch all the time, and way worse. He calls all of his partners way worse than that, so... You know. I don't know what he's trying to say here, but...
Because you've told me things that I didn't know that you have talked to him about before. Talking to him about me. You what? Don't you call him. Do not call him.
Do not. I'm afraid of him, K-Shay. Don't
you
call him.
I'm fucking hanging up. Then it's going to be you too.
I love you. I was going to say that. Wait for it. Come on, Lauren. Oh, there's my horse.
No, but we're going to now. No, we haven't, but since he's such a bitch boy, now I'm going to text you, and now I'm going to send you cock pics.
Quack.
Yeah. You fucking motherfucker. You really know how to fucking ruin the shit, don't you, damn? Really know how to fucking ruin it, don't you, damn?
I'm taking your girl, Lauren. That's it.
You ain't taking my fucking girl.
Yeah. I love it. I love it when he sounds like a car having trouble starting in the winter. Fuck you, Dan.
I sent you a picture of my cock lawn. 8 inches. Look at it, bitch.
I didn't even fucking bring up your fucking queer ass fucking pic, you fucking freak.
Look at my cock lawn. Shut up, bitch.
Hey, don't call her a fucking woman, bitch, you fucking cunt hole.
No, I
fucking... You don't have any respect for her at all, do you? You don't have any respect for women at all, do you, Dan?
Yeah, Lauren
you
has
respect for women.
You just
called my fucking woman a bitch.
I'm gonna unmute.
What did you call fucking Emma?
Hot white.
You was close to Emma. What did you call her? You fucking worthless fuck.
Hey, Allison Marie Armstrong.
Hang up on that motherfucker, Casey.
Hang up on him. Punch
hang
him.
Up on
shut
him.
Up, bitch.
You fucking faggot.
Do
you get the
Casey.
Fucking cool, Casey?
Did you guys hear that? Casey was so sad that she was trying to suppress a laugh. Oh, that's too bad. Let's hear that again. Oh.
Do you get the fucking clue, Casey?
Do you get the fucking clue, Casey?
What do you tell me? What do you get for a clue?
I wish she would have said he has an 8-inch dick. That's what you took away?
Who do you think gives a fuck about you more? That fucking faggot?
Seriously?
Or Emma? You stop and think about all the fucking shit Emma has done for you. How much she's been there.
Lauren.
What?
Bah. Oh my god. Not
huh?
The whispers.
No, oh, jeez.
I can't hardly hear you.
But you're a restricted number. You're in rec room. I'm telling you, Casey. This fucking bullshit with Dan is stopping right now.
You know.
I heard you break up with him? You really used the wrong words. It's just them words first. Before I fucking break up. Don't cry. Don't cry. I want adult voice. Don't want the fucking kid voice. I don't want the kid voice. I want you. No, don't do that either. Don't do that, because...
Don't do that.
I didn't do anything to be rude. I'm just asking you to use your regular voice. I know. Then just talk soft.
Kit Kat Meow, if you would have said that last month, I would have lambasted you. But it's not Pride Month anymore, so that's fine. This is just Lauren's way of being a proud gay man. And you know what? Good on him. Look at those dead eyes. Fucking hell, dude. I've never seen someone lick a giant black dildo with as dead of eyes as Lauren. Or just ever. But there he is. He's setting the pace for... whatever.
Doesn't mean you have to use a kid voice.
Yeah, Eureka's mom. He knows his way around. This is not his first big black dick rodeo. Now, granted, it's the first one that hasn't been made out of human flesh, but nevertheless, he remembers some things. Some muscle memories kicking in.
Well, you asked for them, you wanted them, I guess you're getting them. Well,
you're talking very fucking low.
I'm sure you'll look at them. You already told me that you wouldn't pass it up looking at them. I'm sure that's what that fucking queer is sending me too. I'll delete them.
Yeah, I'll look at them for like an hour just to make sure I know what they are, but then I'll delete them.
There you go. Now you can go visit them. Instead of coming to me, you can go to. Fucking visit Dan. I'm just putting all the fucking pieces together in the puzzle.
Pizzas together in the puzzles.
I guess if you want. I'm not mad at you. I'm just telling you, I guess it is. He knows my address. He lives out of the state of Maine. He knows my address. He can come to the state of Maine. He's a lawyer and such a good guy.
Such a good guy.
As you put it, he's a good guy, a good friend. He knows my address, and my address is known. I guess he'll come to me. That cocksucker sent me a little message, and I still ain't listening to looking at that fucking shit.
Hey, Dulty Kong. Donkey Kong. You make me not even like monkeys.
But you got his cock picture there, so I'm sure you're looking at that. That's why you're not fucking responding to me.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah, you're not even answering me now. I'll just let you off the phone so you can take a minute to look at his cock picture.
That's nice of Lauren. It's considerate.
I'm ready for your turn, but I'm fucking telling you. I asked you to fucking get rid of the cocksucker.
That was great. I'm ready for your turn, but first let me talk.
Hang on. Let me take a second. I'm going to have you read to me. Let me take a second, because that he's still fucking texting me and I'm not reading them.
He's so scared to look at a dick pic. Do you think it's because he knows his is really small and he's like, I don't want to be confronted with the reality that I have a weird shaped penis? Or is it just like his general homophobia? Probably the simplest answer is the best, but...
Oh, fucking A.
But he said that he didn't watch porn, so... Maybe the reason that he didn't watch porn was because he didn't want to see... Like, he knows in the back of his mind that his dick is weird and small. I don't know. Yeah, Eureka's mom. He'll jack off to the dick pic later, yeah. He's putting that in the spank bank.
A fucking dish towel. Alright.
I know my dick ain't small.
Because I had fucking strawberries there. Strawberries, and there's some juice on the counter.
There's some juice on the counter. What the fuck are you talking about?
Because I had fucking... strawberries there, and I ate the strawberries, and there was some juice on the counter.
Clean up after yourself. The fuck's wrong with you?
Yeah, and I want you to stop play acting right now, Casey.
Play acting right
now. You're understanding when I tell you that.
Hey, voice to voice and cornhole three-way.
To cry. Why would you cry? Because of Dan?
No. Hey, boo.
Why would you act that way when you knew I weren't yelling at you? You better stop that bullshit now.
Stop your play acting.
You know goddamn well I weren't being mean to you. So you better stop that bullshit. Stop finding some way to make a fucking reaction, Casey, because I'll give you a reaction.
Ooh, whoa. Oh, that sounded like a threat right there. It sounded like if she was there... he would beat her. That's what that sounded like. I mean, obviously, Lorne wouldn't hit a woman because he said so, and Lorne doesn't break his word, you know. But, I don't know about that. And I don't like the sound of that.
You're being the asshole. I didn't even fucking talk nasty. So if you fucking start that bullshit, I'll hang up. I weren't not talking to you nice before.
I weren't not talking to you nice before.
Are you fucking serious? I was telling you, I was wiping out some fucking juice off the counter.
Juice.
I think you better stop that bullshit. Casey, don't do that to me again. If you do that to me again, I'm gonna hang up.
Yeah, Clementine, he's strong, but he's got that gorilla strength. And I don't know how strong he is now, but, you know, when he got out of jail, he had those giant fucking arms. But he can't fight. He's a pussy. I've said it before, like, if you've ever been in a fight, if somebody's ever hit your face, you know that your nose starts bleeding, like, immediately, and then it gets into your mouth, and he's a pussy. So the second he gets a hit, like someone lands any kind of hit on him, he's done. He's going to start crying like a bitch. And he's a coward. Remember he ran and hid in the forest because somebody was stalking him because they were driving past his house? Like, I wouldn't be worried about him in any other fight except for someone who's like frail and small and vulnerable like Winnie. Because even if he had giant arms, like any actual person with confidence... would be able to, you know, get him away. He's half gorilla.
No, there's no if you love me, because you already know I love you. If you love me, you'll be quiet and listen. Listen to your voice when you talk to me. And ask yourself, if you're nice to me. Stop being mean to me, please. That's all I'm asking. Wiping strawberry juice off the counter... Wiping strawberry juice off the counter is not being mean. So you need to find a different fucking thing to say when I am doing that. And between that, you keep saying you can look at his cock for all I care. Listen to me.
Awesome.
Listen to me. Listen to me. If you send any message to me or give me any reason to think that you are so close to Dan, so much closer to Dan than the way you are me, I'm going to hang up the phone. And it will be you and Dan.
Yeah, he's afraid of guys. But also, I don't think that he would hit Debbie. Because she was very intimidating. And I think he'd be too scared to hit her. It would only be someone like Ramona or Winnie. I don't think he'd hit the new Casey. Maybe Jamie. Jamie's, like, kind of dumb. And, like, you know, innocent. She's got the, you know, the babe in the woods quality. So, he might hit her. And he definitely hit a child. Like, Kayla, he would hit her. She was vulnerable. She was, you know, she would not stand up to confrontation. But Debbie would. So, maybe that's controversial, but that's how I feel about him. He would only hit someone that he thought wouldn't try and hit him back. Because he knows any retaliation, and he's a bitch. Okay, that's fair, Slash. I disagree. He feels all women are under him. Yeah, he kind of likes to, like, find women, find something about them that he can have superior over them. But perhaps that's something he does with everyone. I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't feel safe leaving him alone with any woman. I'm speaking, you know, strictly hypothetically. He's a very dangerous individual. And he can justify any action, you know, after the fact. He can retcon any action to make him the victim. He tried to molest a kid, several kids, and he's the victim of that. So there's no, like, moral qualms about him hitting a woman. I think we can all agree on that.
I have had enough of this damn bullshit. It's gonna stop tonight. I already told you. It stopped
right in front of your ears. Hey, Witcher.
Yeah, well...
empty threat was a person, yeah. Yeah, you're not shitting.
It's still texting me.
Polynomial purbred!
I am not telling him. I am sorry for nothing. I didn't do anything to that cocksucker. He's the one that did shit to my best friend and your best friend.
And your best friend.
I am not telling him sorry for fucking nothing. Why you would tell me to say that? Blows my fucking mind. So we can move on. I am not telling him I'm sorry, Casey. Get it out of your fucking head. What the fuck is wrong with you? Dan. I said it to Dan to piss him off. And obviously, he sent my message to you. So, you're obviously communicating with him? No. Fine. No. Communicate with him. What? Then I'm telling you, stop lying to me. Stop lying to me, Casey. Now. No, you shut the fuck up and stop lying to me. Yeah, you're communicating with him a lot more than what you're telling me. You're not being honest with me. You're not being honest with me. Your turn. Be honest with me.
She's trying to, like, quell your issues and your fears, and he's just... Well, you better be honest with me. I'm trying to be honest with you. Can I fucking talk? Well, yeah, you can talk, but first I gotta talk, and I gotta tell you, you better start talking. I'm trying to talk, and every time I try and talk, you talk over me. Well, I'm talking, but you're not talking. I'm trying to get you to talk, but you're not talking. I'm trying to fucking talk, asshole. Could you imagine? I have so much sympathy for his counselor, probation officer, and shit. Imagine trying to talk with this guy. Like, Jesus fucking Christ. Just shut the fuck up. How do you think he thinks he's saying something of value. Do you think he thinks he's adding? You know what? No, scratch that. No one thinks that he's adding. He knows what he's doing. He just wants to be angry. He's comfortable right here, and so he's just going to be a fucking asshole and stay right here. He doesn't want an explanation. He doesn't want it to be okay. He doesn't want to be satiated. He just wants to be pissed off and yell at her and have her be fine with it. And so the longer that he stalls and makes her not able to explain what's going on is the longer that he can be justified in just being angry and abusing her.
It's your turn. Be honest with me.
Hey, Pagemaster.
Apologize. I am not apologizing to him.
Jesus Christ.
To you for what? Sticking up for you? No, idiot. For defending you?
Because you called me a liar and I didn't lie. Because I had blocked him and was reading an old message. Apologize.
Hi, bud.
I'm sorry that I was fucking mean to you. For sticking up for your fucking boyfriend.
Sticking up for you to your fucking boyfriend.
There you go. Where's your apology?
Wow, great apology.
Can you just fucking admit it to it? Isn't that fucking gross?
Oh my God, Jesus Christ.
I just told you, I am sorry for sticking up for you to your boyfriend. Well, I think you better straighten your fucking reasons out. Because you just told me thank you for apologizing to you for that.
Yeah, and right there, people have pointed this out. People have pointed this out as well. Like, he slipped in, like, a little bit of, like, his version. And then when they, you know, acquiesced, just go, whatever. You know, like, you was out on a hot date with Alex last night. Okay, sure, Lauren. So you admit it was a date. Like, no, I'm just taking what I can get from you, because you're a fucking asshole. He doesn't get it. And he thinks, I don't know what he's trying to accomplish there. Like, aha, I've twisted you into telling you into telling the truth. It's like, you know, liar says what? What? Gotcha, bitch. That proves it. Like, no. That doesn't prove anything. Proves that you're a fucking moron.
If you blocked him, and I said something, there's something wrong to you, and mean, then I am sorry.
If that happened, I'm sorry.
For any mean thing I said.
Those are the best kind of apologies.
For anything against you that I said. Well, I didn't say anything against you anyway, so that one didn't make sense.
I have something to apologize for.
I apologize. I'm sorry. No, we're not done with this crap.
Yeah, he just fucking said that.
Yeah, but it's done. Because you know that fuck's not done. What about Emma? What about now that you saw the true side of Dan? What about Emma? Emma was your true friend. She was your literally true friend. If you don't want me to have anything, and you don't want me to have any, listen to me.
Listen.
If you don't want me to have anything to do with Emma until you're ready for me to have something to do with Emma, then I am fine with that. But you and Emma, you were really good friends.
I'm not gonna apologize.
And I... You don't need to apologize. You need to talk to her. And she is understanding enough. But really, yeah, you should apologize to her because of the words that you said to her.
I have a confession.
Because she fucking... She thought a lot more of you than that. What? Alright. I'm never gonna be. Why would you do that? What? Wait a minute, Casey. You thought Dan Emma was dead because you wanted Dan.
Don't be mad. That was then. This is now. I didn't know how he really was. Okay?
No. Wait a minute. You told me that Emma was dead so that you could have Dan and not me? So you wanted Dan and me?
I wanted him to be sad and cry on my shoulder and send me pictures of his cock, but I don't want that anymore.
Are you fucking kidding? God damn it!
Please don't be mad. Let's work through this. I love you.
How can you... You've been telling me you love me all along and I've been believing you.
I do. I just get horny. It's just sex.
Call Dan now. Call Dan now. Paul, I'm not going to hang up as long as you say the right words, and I'm not going to say anything. I'm not even here, but I am hearing everything.
As long as you do what I want, I'll keep abusing you. That sounds like a square deal. All right, I'm on Team Lauren here.
That you say. You think about it. You think about it, it's all going to be on your head.
No, because I didn't do anything wrong. Let's work.
No. Let's work together. This is going to tell me everything.
Shut up. Let's work together like partners, okay? What's our game plan?
There's no game plan. I want you on the phone with Dan. You're the only one that knows that I'm here. I'm going to see what you tell him. I'm listening. Just know that I'm listening.
Do you think that this, like, plays into his, like, weird perversions of, like, voyeurism? We know he's, like, an exhibitionist, and apparently he's, like, stalked some people in real life. That woman that was going to live in his shipping container and was like, fuck no. And, of course, Nikki, and probably Paula, like, almost certainly Paula. Do you think that this plays into it? Why, that's why he likes to be, you know, on mute and listen to other people, talk to other people about him. But it seems really perverse. Like, I wouldn't want to do that. Like, I don't care. Out of sight, out of mind. But he's really, he loves this shit.
Hello? Hello?
Hey.
You blocked me?
Yeah, on my cell phone.
You blocked me.
Oh, you fucking faggot. She can only talk so long, so now I'm gonna talk for you, fucking queer.
So he was on mute for like 4 seconds. Alright, great work, Lauren. Great sleuthing. You know?
You're not getting her. You want more than 8 inches? I'm gonna give you more than 8 inches because my foot is gonna go up your fucking ass and you're gonna be down for the fucking count. And after you're down for the count, I'm gonna stomp on your fucking head. So why don't you bring your ass up the fucking main? You are very, very fucking lucky that she can't speak loud. Because I'm speaking loud for her now.
If you were going to give
matter
me...
You don't even need for anybody to be out of anywhere. You bring your ass up to me right now. And it'll be me and you. Let's see how tough you are, you fucking queer. You know my address. I'm inviting you to my house right now. Let's see how tough you are, you fucking queer. You want to fucking talk to talk? You want to talk to talk, you little fucking bitch? You walk the walk, you fucking little cunt.
No,
you're about ready to get your fucking ass beat like a motherfucker. Because if you don't show up at my house, you're nothing but a talking fucking bitch. A little fucking bitch. Bitch. No. Hang up on him, Casey. Hang up on him, Casey. Hang up on him, Casey.
Okay.
Hang up on him.
Okay.
Ladies, he's single. Hey, Pine Baron Patriot.
Did you hang up on him?
She just said that she hung up on him.
Okay. Now it's your turn to listen.
Now
okay?
She's been listening the whole time. The fuck are you talking
about? I'm
gonna
call. And I want you to remain completely quiet.
And I want you right there and him right okay? there.
Huh? Huh? Okay, because I've got his number. I've forgotten. I have D, the letter D, on my phone, and I've got his number. It's Dan.
Do you have a D switcher?
I didn't remember who it was before, but when I put the... Okay, that's fine. Do a private call. I just want you to remain completely silent.
Okay.
Completely. I'm tired of him calling you bitching. You better not. You had literally better not be playing this fucking game with me with this fucking piece of shit queer. Listen to me. You're not doing anything wrong.
Listen,
I'm just letting you know up front. You better not be playing a game with me.
Yeah, just letting you know up front. I don't think you are, but I think you are. So don't be playing a game with me.
All right.
Hello, this is Dan.
Oh, Dan sounded so pleasant. You know, he just really went through the ringer and then got a random call and answered, "Hello, this is Dan," very sweetly. Wow. Good on Dan. He's a very composed individual. Hey, Duchess.
What's up, Dan?
What's up, Dan?
Hey, what's up, chicken tenders?
I was right back into the fray.
It's just me and you now, tough guy.
Oh, I can't wait to fucking fill your girlfriend's cunt with a real cock.
Boom, got him.
A real cock? You ain't got a fucking real cock.
8 inches,
a real
bitch.
Cock. Everybody's seen your little pathetic fucking pepperoncini. I got a real cock, motherfucker. You got a fucking little Italian pepper.
You know, an awful lot of people obsessing over my cock, Dan.
Yeah, because it's weird. It's a weird cock. People are, they're not obsession is not always positive. You know, people were obsessed with the Amber Heard trial. They weren't praising Amber Heard. Oh, Lorne.
Come on, Peppa Boy.
Peppa Boy.
An awful lot of people.
Hello, little kid lover. Good to see you again.
A lot of people are obsessing over my cock, Dan. How many people are obsessing over yours?
No, I got a fucking 8 inches of hard salami, baby.
Hard
salami.
Eight inches.
I'm gonna fuck eight inches,
Dan. You usually people that say they have 8 inches, they usually have maybe fucking 3 if they're lucky.
No. Look at the message I sent you. I showed you a picture of my cock. A real cock.
A real cock.
You know what, Dan? I didn't bring up your fucking message because you're saying super shit.
Yeah.
Don't you talk about my fucking mother. My mother is 77-year-old fucking woman, Cyberstreak. Fuck you.
You don't want to see a real cock. I'm going to bust your fucking ass when I go to Cornville.
Jesus,
I'm
going to
fuck you up.
Dan, did you say you're a lawyer?
Yeah.
You know, I have never met a lawyer that sounds as stupid as you do.
Hey, the
I'm
Lord
as
files.
Good in the boxing ring as I am in the courtroom, baby.
There
stupid
it is.
As you do.
I'm as good in the boxing ring as I am in the courtroom, baby.
That's like the promo, you know, when they're like, doing the interviews before the fight. He's as good in the boxing ring as he is in the courtroom, baby. Dan O'Connor, standing at 6'5", 280 pounds of pure muscle. And in this corner, Lauren Armstrong, 5'4", with shoes on, weighing 212 pounds of pure something, of pure ham cubes. What else does he eat? Ham cubes and fruit juice.
Good in the boxing ring as in the courtroom.
Really?
Ding, ding, motherfucker.
Really? Really, motherfucker?
Well, why don't you meet me in a fucking street fight, even or a boxer, I don't give a fuck what it is.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to beat the living fuck out of you.
I'm gonna fuck you up.
Bring it up there, Dan. Don't talk it, so-called lawyer boy.
Lawyer boy, classic.
Oh, that was an
Boom.
Insult? Lawyer boy? Okay,
lawyer
what are you,
boy.
Unemployed? You bitch.
I'm not unemployed, I work.
Oh, Dan got him good right
there. I have a job, Dan.
Unemployed
20 hours
boy.
A week?
20?
Yeah.
Dan, why don't you get up and fucking...
20? More like 22, Dan. Get your facts straight.
12:30 in the morning. Then work till fucking 3:30 the next afternoon.
Oh, so you work graveyard shift, so you're a big fucking...
Clementine, yeah, he's like 5'7 with shoes on, with like, you know, platform boots, work boots on. So shave off at least an inch. He's like 5'6 max. Probably closer to 5'5 realistically.
And hero?
You're a lawyer and you can't figure out the math on that?
And you can't figure out the math? Gotcha.
Wake
Boom.
Up at 12:30 in the morning, Dan.
Lauren's gotcha. Lauren's gotcha right there, Dan. You're a lawyer and you can't do the math on that? Lawyers famously do math all day. Come on.
And they get done work at 3:30 in the afternoon. You're a lawyer and you can't figure out the math on that? You're not a very fucking smart lawyer, are you?
You can't do the math on that, Lauren.
You just fucking step yourself right into a hole every time you open your mouth.
I'm going to use your girlfriend like a blow-up fuck doll. Do you understand me?
That's a pretty good response. Smoker.
Do you understand me? I'm going to fuck you.
You wait till I say the word on how intelligent you sound.
What the fuck did he just say? You need to get that 8 inches cock out your throat, Lauren.
You wait until I pass the word on how intelligent you sound.
Okay, yep, we're gonna... Classic segment time. We're gonna pause that background music, and we're gonna slow this bitch down. We are gonna figure out what the fuck he just said.
Until I pass the word on how intelligent you sound.
What the fuck? That's not English. Let's get it back at normal speed.
Sound. You wait until I pass the word on how intelligent you sound.
Okay, I'm playing video games, so I'm not like facing the computer. So I gotta get in the upright position, head even with the monitor here. Let's get that again.
You wait until I pass the word.
You wait. That doesn't look... Okay. Oh, outdoor loser. I think you're right. You wait until I tell my lawyer how intelligent you sound. I think you're right. Let's get that again.
You wait until I pass the word on how intelligent you sound.
I know, I'm shifting into focus mode, Allison. I'm using all of my FBI skills here. And I think that Outdoor Loser is right. It's just he, like, trips over his words a lot.
You wait until I pass the word on how intelligent you sound.
You wait until I will intelligent you sound. It's complete. It's just nothing. He might have meant, you wait until I tell my lawyer how intelligent you sound, but... Fucking hell. Pass the word around? I don't hear that.
You wait until I pass the word on how intelligent you sound.
It kind of sounds like that. This is like deciphering, you know, like ghost hunters when they get like a EVP. And they're like, oh my god, what does it say? And it's like, shh, shh, shh. And you're like, it said it's in the bushes. No, it didn't. Hey, Cat G. All right, let's move on. I've spent enough time on literally nonsense. Let's get back to more nonsense.
Take me one in a fight. You can't.
It's true.
Bring yourself up here, Dan.
Bring yourself up here, Dan.
You're fucking flabby.
Dumbass. I'm inviting you up here.
Smoke another.
I'm inviting you up here.
You can't laugh.
Clementine, because Dan is supposedly a lawyer. So he's going to tell his lawyer that his fake friend, who's fucking his best friend, who doesn't talk to him anymore, and wants to fuck his girlfriend, who is the girl that caught him on To Catch a Predator, which wound him up in jail, that he doesn't sound very intelligent. That's what he's going to tell his lawyer. And that's going to go over very smoothly. I'm sure the lawyer will be happy to hear about those developments. I'm sure Lauren and his lawyer will have a good laugh about how stupid this Dan guy sounds. You know what I mean? Oh, boy.
You have no reason not to show up.
I'm coming there, Mike.
Zero reason, queer boy. You have zero reason to not show up here.
I thought it was lawyer boy.
Zero. So instead of fucking talking, just show up.
Just
zero reason to not show up.
Prison, motherfucker.
Whatever talk you're talking, man, I don't hear you. Just show up.
You're gonna be washing my drawers. Do you understand me?
Yeah, but the problem is.
Even listen in the background, even Emma's like, what the fuck?
Do you understand me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll pause the background music here again. Listen closely. Zoom and enhance, everyone, on the audio here.
Washing my drawers. Do you understand me?
Yeah, but the problem is, you come in your fucking drawers and want to wash them because they're going to fucking dunk your ass in the fucking stream down the fucking road.
When's the last time your drawers go
Do you
washed?
Not understand me?
You dirty bitch.
Let me give you a little fucking hint to this.
Okay.
You're going to show up in my fucking dooryard.
Dooryard?
I'm gonna grab you by the fucking hair, drag you down to the fucking brook.
Brook?
And I'm gonna dunk your ass in the fucking water.
Aaron's
and that's
wife?
Where your door's gonna be fucking washed because you'll be shitting your britches.
So that'll be perfect. When I come up out of the water and I'm all dripping and looking sexy for your girlfriend Casey, so I beat your ass in front of her and then I have a nice fuck fest.
Yeah. And now I know you're living in a dreamland because when you come up out of the fucking water, you're just going to be dunked back under again.
Lauren, just get that dick out of your mouth. Jesus Christ. I know you like sucking on the Montre, but now is not the time, good sir.
When I'm done with... You
come up out of the water, I'm going to have the fucking nearest queer in the fucking neighborhood to fucking bend you over and start fucking you.
When I'm done with your girlfriend...
Then I'm going to dunk you under the water again.
Why does Lauren know so much about the goings-on of the gay community in Cornville? He's got gay neighbors that will come over and readily have sex with someone in a brook behind his house. He knows that they all go to the Blue Moon Bar. Like, Lauren is really tapped in to the gay scene in Cornville, Maine. That's curious. Hey, size of a beetle bug.
Have the nearest dog in the neighborhood, bite your fucking little pecker, your 2-inch pecker off.
Listen,
they don't want to come up out of the water again, then.
Okay.
I'm just going to start beating the living fuck out of you because you called my girlfriend a fucking bitch.
This is an interesting scenario.
Not only is your girlfriend a bitch, when I'm done...
You know, it sounds like Lauren's put a lot of thought into this. Like, many a daydream has been spent thinking about, you know, how Lauren can watch Dan have sex, apparently, you know? Huh.
Your girlfriend. Dan. I'm gonna Dan. Fuck your mother. I'm gonna fuck
Dan,
her.
You are,
you're fucking
Dan, mother. You and that. Hey, Chris,
fuck your mother. Fuck her.
You're never gonna touch my girlfriend.
I'm gonna fuck your mother, too.
All right, Dan. You wanna talk about my girlfriend?
Why, Allison? Is it because she's black? Hashtag cancel Allison.
Friends of my mother. All right, motherfucker.
Your sister's gonna suck
I'm gonna find out your address now, motherfucker.
Oh, yeah? Because
you guys are the two people in the world that I care most about.
About?
I'm gonna find out your...
Now, granted, one of them I've never met, but I stand by it.
Fucking address, motherfucker. And you know I can because you know how close me and them are. So now I'm gonna find out your address. I'm coming down to your house, and you're gonna be fucking dead.
Hey, Lauren, I'm coming for you.
You want to save my fucking girlfriend, my fucking mother? I'm coming down to your house now, motherfucker.
You created
a major issue, motherfucker.
You created a major issue. I love how he says created right there. You created a major issue.
Now, motherfucker. You created a major issue, motherfucker.
Your mother.
Casey, hang up on that bitch. Hang up on that bitch now.
Asshole.
Hang up on him. Casey! Hang up on that bitch.
Okay, this next call. Oh my god. This next call. I was about halfway through it. I was listening to it. I don't remember having heard it. I'm sure I have. But I was about halfway through it, and then it got really good. And I was like, I gotta listen to the rest of this on stream. So... it might be kind of shitty in the back half, but I know that these next few minutes are going to be fucking gold because I heard them. And let me like this video here. And here we go. This is called Lauren Rages Against Wendy and Dan. Major issues.
I promise I won't stick my face in. I swear I love you, and I will never stick my face in front of Dan's cock when he shoots his load of glory again, ever.
I swear I'll believe you when you show up.
Okay. What are you eating? You still sound like you're fat.
As far as that stupid picture you just fucking sent me, the best thing...
And before anybody corrects my grammar... the title is Lauren's Rages Against Wendy and Dan, and only Dan is capitalized. So, there you go.
What you do is never send me stupid pictures again.
You don't even know what that is.
I know there's a D on it.
That's right. You know what it stands for?
You want to tease the fuck out of it.
Boom. The smoking gun. There's a D on it. Gotcha, bitch.
Tease the fuck out of me. How about Dan? Best thing for you to do is to stop doing that.
Yeah.
Gigi's last name is Dallin.
I don't do shit to tease you about any fucking woman. Stop your fucking moron bullshit
moron
teasing me about
bullshit.
Any fucking guy. Because this is royally getting fucking old and sickening. Disgustingly fucking sickening.
Okay.
Stop your stupid fucking bullshit. We already agreed on it earlier today.
Gee.
And you're already pulling the fucking bullshit.
Listen.
Stop your fucking disgusting bullshit.
Stop your fucking disgusting bullshit.
My fucking disgusting.
I'm not gonna listen.
Yeah, Chupa grandson. He's like 48 at the time of this. Winnie would be like late 40s.
Disgusting bullshit.
My fucking disgusting.
I'm not gonna listen. I am not gonna listen. You're gonna fucking listen.
Okay.
You're gonna pull this.
You know, I gotta give Lauren points for being honest there. I'm not gonna listen is the truest thing he may have ever said. He might as well go into his like therapy sessions with I'm not gonna listen.
Bullshit. Stop your retarded bullshit.
Okay.
I don't want to hear another fucking word about Dan.
So he's shifted from like gay slurs to like mentally disabled slurs. Okay, you know, it's not progress, but it is different. So that's something. Hey, Ellie Elias and Ma'am Yes Ma'am.
Don't want to hear another fucking word about Dan. Do you understand me on this shit? Because you're fucking pushing it. Call Dan. Call Dan. Call your fucking lover.
Well, Chupa Grandson says Lauren should be Kingpin in the porn parody of Spider-Man with Jamie Amy as MJ and Will as Peter. Well, obviously, MJ would have to be Maggie Jo. And then Jamie Amy can play, you know, Spider-Woman, Gwen Stacy, from a parallel universe. I mean, you know, come on, Chupa Grandson. I might have to take that wrench away.
You wanna push him on me? Call your fucking lover!
I'm gonna put it on me. Fuck everybody, let's just go. We can smoke bud, have some fun, and blow a chode.
King Ding.
Dan.
What the fuck do you want?
Good question.
Tease me more about Dan?
Tease?
What are you
eating? Got some other fucking guy you want to tease me about?
Are you going to buy me a whoopie pie?
Those are the only two options. You know, look, are you going to cheat on me with this guy or some other guy? In Lauren's mind, one cannot not be cheating on him.
What are you
eating?
You got
some other fucking guy you want to tease me about.
Are you going to buy me a whoopie pie?
You got some other guy you want to tease me about?
No.
You just want to keep teasing me about Dan. Call Dan.
Okay.
Call Dan.
Okay.
Call your lover.
Hello?
Give me a kiss. Give me kisses.
What?
Oh, fucking bullshit. Stop fucking lying to me.
I'm not gonna call him. It's 5 a.m., stupid.
So you're actually calling Dan this time?
I'm not gonna call him. It's 5 a.m. You're going to be drunk and yelling at him for no reason. He's not Wendy, the fat cunt, or Tony, the user, loser. He didn't do anything wrong, so leave him alone.
I'm not. Exactly. Dan didn't do anything wrong, so I'm not going to yell at Dan.
Well, good.
I just want you to tell Dan exactly what you've been doing.
Okay, I'll tell him. Hold on. Are you there?
I'm here.
Oh, I thought you said you're black inside.
What?
I was like, what? Wow. You went outside and you painted your fingernails black and fingered yourself out there at the same time. Is that why you're black inside? That was really funny, huh?
That's pretty good, yeah.
I don't know who you're talking to.
You.
Did you hear he just stuffed something into his fat fucking mouth? It's probably another dick, right? It's probably LaMondre again. Back at it. Hey, we're talking about him being black inside. That makes sense.
I don't know who you're talking to. I don't know who you're talking to.
Yo. Did you get your nails painted for me? Yeah, they're all pink and pretty.
At the tone, please record your message. When you're finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more.
Oh, right, Eureka's mom. It's biscuits and gravy without the biscuits or really even the gravy. Of course.
Or options.
Oh, Cat G, I don't have confirmation, of course, whether or not his parole officers have seen him with LaMondre, but I'm sure they get a dozen pictures of him with LaMondre in his mouth every day. Like, I've never sent one in, but, you know, you got me thinking, Cat G. You got me thinking. I'm sure other people have sent in pictures of LaMondre. Probably a lot. That may very well be the number one picture of Lauren that they've received.
Dan, it's me.
Dan, I...
I am having a
pedo gravy and government cheese, hey boo.
Difficult time. This man's living the life. Drunk pedophile right now. His name is Warren.
Oh, what the fuck?
What the fuck?
I don't love you, Dan, but I'd let you fuck the brains out of me. Hi.
Seems like you want to put me down. Do you love her?
No, he couldn't answer, sweetie.
Oh, your lover couldn't answer. I noticed that.
Well, I think that they can. People have definitely sent his PO information before. I mean, it's the main probation office, which should be, you know, easy to find. They probably put, like, this information pertains to Lauren Armstrong or something along those lines. I have no idea how one would, but I imagine it can't be impossible.
I don't have a leather.
Oh, yeah, you do. You come all over your face.
Oh, God, that's cute.
Hey, George Glass.
You're so dainty. Lauren, you're so dainty the way you move your hands and you walk. Did you know that? Lauren.
What?
Trailers.
Did you know they wanted to make the Brawny Man a combination of the Marlboro Man and Paul Bunyan?
Yeah, did you know that I want a woman that actually loves me and doesn't fucking dick around with other guys?
Irrelevant.
Did you know you don't fucking deserve that, bitch?
That's true.
And did you know you don't deserve somebody that fucking loves you because you can't stop dicking around with other guys?
Oh, man, Winnie just made a great point. Let's get that again. Well said, Winnie. You know, she has her gems.
That bitch.
And did you know you don't deserve somebody that fucking loves you because you can't stop dicking around with other guys?
He didn't hear that.
I love... Lamangelo.
Oh, yeah, Lamangelo.
Oh, you love Dan.
No, I like fruit in my Jell-O.
You love Dan for months. Since you fucking met Dan. You love Dan, and I became a fucking second.
No.
Because you can't stop your bullshit with Dan.
I can't help it.
Oh, yeah, you can. Yeah, you can. You just choose not to because you think that's the best way to make me fucking
Listen,
feel jealous.
Listen, Dan is Black Fabio. He's
when all you have done
Start yelling.
Is push me away because you can't stop your stupid bullshit with Dan.
On hair.
Come on, Lauren. You're pushing
me to the point where I'm going to start looking for other women in this area.
Oh, no!
Because
Don't
you
do
can't
that,
stop your stupid bullshit with Dan.
Yeah. Yell at her.
Go ahead, baby. If you can find a woman before I get out there, I'll fucking pay for your wedding. But you can't, like, tie her down anywhere. You do so cute when you make me happy.
And she has to be
You don't want me to try? If you don't want me to try, then you probably ought to shut your fucking mouth. About Dan.
No, she does want you to try. That's what she's saying. It's like he can't... Did he not hear her? Or did he not understand it?
You probably ought to fucking burn that fucking sweatshirt.
Burn
Whatever
that fucking sweatshirt.
Whatever fucking tattoo you had on there, you probably ought to get rid of it. You probably ought to stop your stupid fucking bullshit with Dan.
Yeah, keep yelling.
Because you are killing us. You alone are killing us.
There you go. This is working.
Because you're fucking bullshit with Dan. Don't
hey.
Stop your bullshit. Who's this? Who are you? Who? Miguel?
Miguel?
Miguel, did you know? You know that for months she has been teasing me about you. Then you know a little bit about what's going on, so but you don't need to know everything.
George Glass, Lauren? Dumb? Are we talking about the Lauren Armstrong? The pedophile who's been catfished for a decade? I don't know. I don't know about that. I've heard some things. I've heard some tales about Lauren, but, you know. Dumb? I don't know.
And I'm not quitting you on my relationship, so get the fuck out.
I don't know
out.
If I'm ready to believe
yeah,
that quite
You're
yet.
A fucking faggot.
I think I'm going to need a few more catfishes before I say dumb, but, you know, we'll see.
So, but you don't need to know everything, and I'm not quitting you on my relationship, so get the fuck out. Yeah? And you're a fucking faggot. Fuck you, bitch.
What?
He can't leave the state. That's why he can't come over here.
Oh, okay. Why not? Is he like a child sex predator or something?
What do you want?
Hi.
Don't fucking hide me. You constantly want to pull fucking people in on our conversation? Like that fucking faggot Miguel?
Remember when you made
fuck
me call
you.
Josh and you made me talk to him and
fuck
you
Fuck you, Winnie!
Yeah, yell at her.
You don't fucking love me. All you want to do is pull people in on our fucking relationship. Fuck you. I'm not playing your fucking game.
Okay.
It's still playing. I think she hung up on him. And now he's gonna bitch about why she hung up on him. Why would you hang up on me just because I'm abusing you? That's a piss poor excuse.
Hey, it's me. You can call me if you want to.
Okay, yeah, so she did hang up on him. And he called her back.
Sorry, the person you are trying to reach has a voicemail box that has not been set up yet. Please, try your call again later.
He hasn't set up his voicemail.
Hey, it's me. You can call me if you want to. Bye.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey, it's me. You can call if you want to.
Hey, it's me. You call me if you want to.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Don't ever bring another fucking person in on our relationship again.
Okay.
Don't ever let anybody see me abusing you again.
Do you want to jack off now?
Oh, Winnie.
Oh, Miguel. You ready to knock him? You want to jack off in front of you?
No, he came in early today.
You got Dan on the other one? You got jack off on you?
No, not this time. I'm not sure.
Not this time?
I'm interested in.
How many times has he done it?
No.
Never.
No.
I always slipped under on one of those mechanic creepers, like when you change the oil. But And it was like, hey, squirt, squirt. It was really funny.
Winnie?
What?
You really ought to think about things before you say that.
They used to call me Miss Creeper.
You have not put me and you in a very good position at all.
Okay.
It doesn't sound like she gives a shit.
Just when I really think that you're in love with me and don't want anybody else, you pull the...
What did he say earlier? Was it Outdoor Loser? Did you have a theory about what he said earlier? Oh, I tell my lawyer about how intelligent you sound. Was that it? I already forgot.
Bullshit out. Fucking wanting somebody else more than you want me.
Can you do a Tommy Chong impression, please?
Yeah, please.
No.
Hey, man.
Okay, I will. Hey, man. My boyfriend's being mean, man. All I want to do is kiss him, man. I'm so high, man. Shut up, Lauren. I love you, fucking butthole.
Yeah, well, prove it. Keep other people out of our relationship.
For a big old wiener because you just took a fist and a foot. That's pretty hot, actually. Bob Barker hot, yo.
Keep other people out of our relationship.
Remember when Joe Camel was a cartoon character on all the magazines?
And that fucking Miguel? Tell me he needs to shut his fucking mouth to me.
Okay. But he's my character.
He's fired right now.
If he hears somebody verbally abusing me, he's not going to be like me and just take your word for it that you're not.
As far as I am with him right now, if I ever see him face to face, I'll fucking knock his ass out. That motherfucker doesn't know me.
So the theme of the night is Lauren solving his problems with fake over-the-phone violence. Okay. Good to know.
Tell him. Tell him. Miguel, come here.
That cocksucker don't know me for fucking shit. Tell him shit. I don't want to fucking hear his. I don't want to hear his fucking voice. Keep other people out of mine and your relationship. It's not hard.
Stop yelling at her.
Mine and your. Not our. Mine and your. He had to go first. It's my relationship and yours, but mostly mine.
Shut
not
up,
ours.
You stupid fuck! Okay. You don't fucking yep. know me. Shut the fuck up!
I thought you wanted to.
I don't want to hear his voice, Winnie.
Winnie.
Am I scared? Okay. You're gonna be scared if we have me face to face, bitch.
What? What did he just say to her?
Okay. You're gonna be scared if we have voice, Winnie. Am I scared? Okay. You're gonna be scared if we have me face to face, bitch.
Did he just threaten Winnie, like, overtly?
Scrawny fuck.
Oh, is he? He's talking
shut
about Miguel.
Shut up and go wash your fucking face.
What? Who's he talking about?
Go paint your fucking fingernails.
Earlier,
you
I
fucking
was
girl.
Like I was corn eating me out, and I stuck my face in the ravioli bowl.
Hey, Donde and Trailer 11.
I did. I my friends saw me. They can vouch for the ridiculousness. Hold on, they're all in my head, right? Hi.
Are you done impressing your fucking buddy?
I wanted you to tell him off.
Boy, buddy.
I wanted you to tell him off. Good job.
Why? Cause he's been feeling your pussy for the last few months.
What?
For the last month.
No.
Yeah, Cyberstreak.
Had to have a fucking guy taking care of your fucking pussy. Couldn't have been a girl.
Have a guy taking care of
you. All that much better with me and you. That's
I'm not gay, baby.
Not everything is about you,
that's
asshole.
That's why your proctologists are all men.
Oh, that's why all my proctologists are men, huh? Because you think I'm gay?
No.
What?
Well, aren't you just choosing some really fucking really bright words?
I love you, baby. Come on. Yeah, that's
yeah, well,
you don't do that skin unless
everything you're saying sounds like shit that Xavier Von Erich was set up to say.
Okay, listen. Do you want to know what I'm saying? I'm saying lyrics from a Wu-Tang Clan song I've been singing all day called "Bring the Fucking Cock Eyes." Do you want to hear all the lyrics?
You ever stop and think that you and I have not met face to face yet?
Uh-huh.
And with the start that we had.
You know, it's kind of telling he uses phrases like, why don't you concentrate on it? And have you ever stopped to think? Like, I think that Lauren can't, like, just passively have thoughts. I think, like, even something simple, he has to, like, really sit and think about it. Like, in his truck, I think turning is an event for him in his truck. Like, he's got to stop and think. Like, I have to turn right now. Now I'm turning right. The direction I'm turning is right. Like he has to stop for a second and really think about where he's going. He can't just passively be driving. And he thinks everyone else has that inability to think passively as well.
Xavier Von Erich was telling you everything to say. And it was the stupid shit that you said tonight.
To neat.
Uh-huh.
You think maybe I'll think more about the shit that you say?
Oh, okay. Okay, I have a way to prove to you that I love you. Are you ready?
Why, how? By putting Miguel on the phone?
No. Are you ready?
By getting some other guy involved in our relationship?
Yeah, kind of. Listen.
Yeah, figures.
Oh, what you are. Come be my coffee table, and I'll be your sofa. I unbelievable, so near yet so far. Come be my metal cable to my cable car. You blossom like a flower. You have to sit like vegetable.
Wow, no one thinks he's street. Hey, Dan Jones.
That's for you, baby.
What's not to understand, Clementine? He's street. I'm telling you out street. I'm street. Not gay and I'm not bi. I'm street. So no one thinks Lorne is street? Good, me neither. I don't think he's street.
No, yo.
Or it could mean, like, he's street. Like, he grew up on the streets, you know? He's like, yo, yo, yo. That's what people from the street sound like, right? Oh, yeah.
You don't love it?
No.
No?
It'd mean a lot more if I knew you being honest with me. But with as much as you want to get fucking people involved in our relationship, and as much as you want to tease me about Dan.
Cat G, the question is, Lorne is A, gay, B, bi, C, not gay and not bi, and D, street.
You know, it makes it really difficult.
Look, I want you to just be, like, really normal.
I thought it meant he was for the streets. Well, then why didn't you vote for it, George Glass? He's obviously for the streets.
Relax, okay?
Yeah,
Again, you know, you're starting a car in the winter. It's negative 24 degrees outside. You're trying to start your car.
Why'd you turn the music off?
Nice bass. Nice bass. Nice bass.
Oh, that's all I ever do is listen because you don't fucking matter what I say. You do what you want.
Nice piece, all for only one.
It's a monster thinking of, it's a burning monster.
Is this anime? I don't know what's going on.
Would you like to know what I would like to hear you do?
No, thanks. Would you like to hear what I'd like you to do? It's always about him.
Would you like to know what I would like to hear you do?
Would you like to know what I would like to hear you do? I. Fucking, he's like a seagull, you know?
I don't know how to sing in Japanese, but I'd like to. I want to learn this song.
Okay, what I'm saying is, would you like to know what I would like you to do?
No one gives a shit.
You gonna turn that piece of shit music off? Because that shit sucks.
No, it doesn't. I love it. Nice piece, all for only
one. You obviously don't want to hear anything I have to say.
I want to hear it, but like, George Strait is much shittier than this. Look at this guy.
No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Okay, first thing you can do is tell Miguel, I'm sorry I put you in the middle of mine. And again, you don't hear anything I have
to say. She doesn't give a shit what you want her to do. She's not going to give in to what you want her to do just because you tell her. He can't. It's the same with all these. You'd think after all these years, he'd wrap his mind around it. Like, oh, people aren't just going to do what I want them to do because I tell them, here's what you need to do. He can't. He just fucking can't. Anyone who doesn't think he's a narcissist, at least on some level, what is holding you back? What is stopping you from thinking that? He's so fucking entitled. How would anyone think he's not a narcissist who's listened to the calls?
Do it right here and I'll turn it off. Okay, that's all. Beep. Go ahead, baby.
What I like to do is tell Miguel, I'm sorry I put you in the middle of my and my boyfriend's issues.
Lauren is sorry that he put
my boyfriend's issues.
One more time. That was a great issues.
Miguel, I'm sorry I put you in the middle of my and my boyfriend's issues.
Lauren is sorry that he put the middle of him and his
boyfriend. No, no.
Nope. Oh my god.
Wow.
In the middle of him and his
No.
Somebody clip that. That was great. This is in Lauren's Rages Against Wendy and Dan on Prince Cod channel. I linked it in the description. This is at 51 minutes and 6 seconds.
Lauren is sorry that he put in the middle of him and his
Nope. Oh.
Wow.
Why don't you do your own dirty work, bitch?
Yeah, bitch.
I'm getting drunk too, but at least I'm not being mean to Lauren. Oh, wait, I am. Hi!
What do you want?
What do you want?
I love you.
You don't prove it.
Well, yeah. Better start proving it.
No, you don't. You're trying to fucking blow off everything I say. You don't give a fuck about anything I say.
Why not?
It's all what you say. That matters.
I love it. I know, because they are
even what that fucking Miguel says is more important to you than what I say. But he's been feeling your pussy for the last month.
Hey, you guys want to go over to the Wits End after this? You think they got some ice cream? I could go for like some waffles. I bet they got waffles. Let's go get some waffles after this. Maybe some ice cream. We'll see if they have ice cream. But maybe waffles.
So, no wonder.
He has that thing that Crestfallen has in the hair.
Oh, I know. He probably has all kinds of fucking things.
Hey, Lauren.
What?
Lauren.
What do you want, fucking woman that don't give a fuck about me?
I googled how much the most expensive Kirby vacuum is, and it's $1,700. Your mom
the Clits End. Oh, she got her fucking vacuum for free.
Then why is she bitching about it's making a profit if they already gave her $50 for it?
Listen. Listen!
Oh my god! No. Holy shit!
Listen!
Winnie just pointed out that, like, that Kirby vacuums aren't as expensive as his mom paid. And listen to how much he freaks out in like 2 seconds.
Profit if they already gave her $50 for it.
Oh, catchy. Of course, we're going to play Twister first. We're going to go see 3 movies, then we'll play Twister, then we'll shower, and then we'll go to the Wits End.
Listen! Yeah, listen!
Okay. That was at $52.50.
$50 for it.
Listen! Listen! Listen!
Jesus Christ!
No. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
You want to fucking hell. Fuck you. Trying to put my fucking mom down. Fuck you.
Chavoso, puta de la madre.
What the fuck is going on in this call? This went off the rails really quick.
Mames, pelame, cabrón.
Hey, what the fuck do you want?
Hi.
You got your fucking buddy there, Miguel?
Yeah, I'm sure that lesson is doing wonders for Sadie's skittishness.
So Bella, maybe because
tell Bella Miguel go fuck himself.
I mean,
and you can fucking love Miguel all you fucking want. I will leave you two alone.
Primarily,
you can be together. All right, that's what you want.
He's clean. Can...
Sir, we don't have the Legos that you wanted.
Mom,
52.50, I think.
No. Fuck you. Listen.
Me going to the Lego store. They're like, sir, it turns out we've sold out of those Legos that you wanted.
Listen!
$50 for it.
Listen. Listen. Listen!
My dad teaching me math.
Gave her $50 for it.
Listen. Listen. Listen!
No. Dad, how does 7 times 4 = 28? I don't understand.
Listen. Oh, listen. God. Listen!
No.
Bella, me because...
Don't fucking want. I will leave you two alone. You can be together. All right? That's what you want. You can be with Miguel. You can be with Dan. Whatever you want. You don't give a fuck about me because you prove it every time you fucking rope in your mouth.
He's cleaning. Your mouth. Right now is the only time there's free parking on the street. He's not allowed to park in the driveway because his truck leaks. He's a Mexican. I mean transmission.
What?
Hi.
Listen. Listen. What? Listen!
Hi.
What do you want?
What do you want?
Why are you mad at me, Precious?
Great question.
I'm tired of your fucking bullshit tonight. You seem to think it's funny. I have not had a good fucking day. You don't give a fuck.
Okay, so confirmation about one of my theories right there. Hey, Rachel, these nuts. Lorne hasn't had a good day, and so now he's just taking it out on Wendy. Or, yeah, Winnie. Wendy, whatever. It says Wendy in the call. That's why I was confused, or in the title. But yeah, so he's just taking it out on her. It's just a thinly veiled... He just found something he doesn't like about her, which is Dan. And he's just being angry about that and taking out his anger on her.
You care about is teasing me.
Teasing me.
Bringing other people in on our relationship. You want Miguel in on our relationship? Somebody we haven't fucking known. You haven't even fucking known for a month.
You just keep yelling at me.
That.
That's all, honey.
Put that motherfucker on the phone and I'll tell him, go fuck him. Fucking self.
Listen.
Why don't you tell him go fuck himself? Does he mean that much to you? Because he's already had his fingers all over your fucking pussy. You had to have a fucking guy making care of you. Couldn't be a fucking girl. Had to be a fucking faggot guy.
Couldn't be a woman either.
They'll get in trouble all on their own because I love you.
Yeah, you fucking get a fucked up way of proving it.
Yeah, well.
A royally fucked up way of proving it.
I got a 98 on my fucking project, baby.
That's great.
Yeah, why don't you get Miguel on the phone and fucking let him cheer us all on?
Oh, yeah, let's not.
Maybe he'll, maybe whatever he says will fucking matter.
You told me to tell him.
Because Miguel is so important. Because Miguel's opinion is so fucking important. Because you've known Miguel a fucking month. He's had his fucking hands all over your pussy.
I share his opinion that I'd like for you to stop yelling.
Instead of having a fucking girl that I wouldn't be jealous of.
Jealous.
I had to have a fucking guy. That's why you fucking did it.
In my butt?
Yeah, in your butt. Miguel's been in your fucking butt. There you go. You fucking said it.
Did you hear that? That was a really good one.
Yo, it's been in your fucking butt. Yeah, in your butt. Miguel's been in your fucking butt.
All right, I gotta go let my dog sit in here for a second. And then when I come back, I think I'm gonna wrap it up. So just a couple more minutes here. And then we're gonna cut it off here tonight. Oh heavens. Oh, a little bit of Lorne goes a long way, you know? My next stream, I'm going to have him crying some. I need some of that after this.
There you go. You fucking said it. Good fucking job. Hope you're real fucking proud of yourself.
Put Miguel in your butt.
You found a way to fucking cheat on your boyfriend without cheating on your boyfriend.
Now put the rock in your butt.
Yeah. You found a way to cheat on your boyfriend without cheating on your boyfriend. So great fucking job. Congratulations.
Eddie Murphy.
Could not have had a girl. You told me yourself you picked all the fucking guy.
Miguel was born a girl.
You chose to have a guy. You chose to have a fucking guy.
I'm sorry. I love you.
No, you're not sorry. You're not sorry because you weren't thinking about me. You were thinking about you.
Okay.
What fucking sexual bullshit you wanted from somebody. It didn't matter that it was not me. it was just some guy that you wanted some guy to take to touch you so you could get a sexual bullshit out of it. Because it did not matter that it was not me. It was just somebody.
I didn't put no boogie in nobody's butt. That's nasty, man. What you talking about? Put boogie in people's butts.
Yes, well, why don't you do this? Considering it's been a month, you're fucking healed up. Why don't you tell Miguel, take a fucking hike. Get
hey,
the
Miguel.
Fuck out.
Yeah.
Don't come back.
Miguel,
yeah.
Put a tree in your butt. Put a bumble bee in your butt. Put a clock in your butt. Now put a big rock in your butt. Okay, Lauren, put some fleas in your butt.
Throw that fucking faggot. Shut the fuck up. I don't give a fuck what he says. But tell Miguel, get the fuck out because you don't need him anymore. It's been a month. You're healed up.
Miguel was in the Marines.
I don't give a fuck what Miguel was in. Why don't you tell Miguel, get the fuck out?
Miguel.
You're all healed up.
Miguel, guess what? Lauren had a Nazi coin with the swastika on it. He does. He's an airman.
Fucking kidding.
Yeah, let's get to know him better before you judge him. No, it was just a cool collector's item. Hi, baby.
Are you talking to me or Miguel?
I'm talking to you.
How should I know? You want Miguel in on everything that we got going. Miguel's been more with you than I have. I probably wouldn't feel this way if you would have had a fucking female nurse, but no, you had to have a guy feeling you up.
Come on, Lauren, let's get it on. Ah! Let's get it on.
If it's not Dan, it's Miguel.
There's nothing wrong with me loving you. I bet that Lauren loves that song.
If it's not Dan, it's Miguel.
That's Miguel.
No,
it's not Miguel. It's somebody else.
I am thinking of you on top of me.
If it's not...
Let's get it on.
Is that... That's Marvin Gaye, right? It's not Sam Cooke. Let's Get It On by Marvin Gaye.
If it's not Dan, it's Miguel.
All right. You know. Oh, got a crick in my neck here. All right. Thanks for joining me. Let me put a pause in this gameplay here. Save some for later, Eel. Come on now. And, yeah, I will see you guys later. I think I'll probably stream on, like, Saturday again. I had a good time doing that. Okay, sing to me. Oh, thank you, Clementine. Okay, yeah, Marvin Gaye, 1974. Thank you, Lenny Wood. And hi, Lenny Wood. I don't think I said hi to you. And Lethal Brownie, hi and bye! All right. I will see you guys Saturday, probably. Until then, you know. Why? Hey, Cheese Max, how are you? I should actually take them for a walk here before the sun goes down. They were just outside, but they were having a good time. I think that they want to go back out there. So, is Here to Party still streaming? If someone could leave the link to his stream, if he's still, they're still going. That'd be dope. Okay, all right. See you guys when I see you guys. Bye.
You need to be back in the arms of a good friend. And I need to be back in the arms of a girlfriend. you need to get back in the arms of a good friend. Oh, 'cause honey, believe me, she'd love to call you my girlfriend. You need.